Breaking tonight, a possible serial shooter on the interstate in Arizona. In the past 2 weeks, 10 different cars are believed to have been shot at. The most recent was just a few hours ago. Police are being careful not to call it a serial shooter, but people in the area are understandably on edge. Director of the Arizona Department of Public Safety, Colonel Frank Milstead, is live in Phoenix. Good evening, Colonel, and tell me about this. How many people have been shot at, and what links them together and what separates them?
We're looking at a total of 11 cases over the last 11 days, Greta. I think we have a couple of different MOs emerging from these cases. We had some that were very similar last weekend, and the four that we've had over the last 4 days appear to be similar as well.
Has anyone seen any shooter, or is it the first notice you get when some car has been hit or some person has been hit?
So far, we have not had a witness other than the victims of the crimes themselves. We've deployed all of the resources of the Arizona Department of Public Safety, along with resources from our federal partners at the FBI and ATF and Phoenix Police Department. So this is job one for my agency, and we will capture whoever this is.
I take it no one's been killed by this, because that would have been my first question to you. No one's been killed, right?
No, we've had one girl injured when a bullet went through the windshield of the parent car and exited the passenger side window. She was cut with some glass fragments. But I would tell you that all of these are lethal events. They're all lethal encounters. And if we don't get a tip that solves this, or we don't solve it ourselves, the danger continues to go up.
Any forensic evidence linking it? Are you able to recover any forensic evidence to show that the same weapon was used, for instance?
We have some information that we've been able to get from these different vehicles. I'm not at liberty to disclose that at this time. I don't want to compromise the case. I'm not trying to be difficult. I just don't want to put the hard work of the men and women involved at jeopardy and possibly jeopardize our ability to prosecute the case.
What's the stretch of highway that this has happened on from the farthest, the two farthest points?
So this piece of highway runs right through the middle of downtown Phoenix. It runs from State Route 51 out to about 59th Avenue, where all of these have occurred for the most part. It's about an 8-mile stretch. The ones that occurred in the last 24 hours are all on the west side of Phoenix between about 35th Avenue and 59th Avenue. Very heavily traversed piece of roadway. It's a very complicated piece to enforce and look for these, these suspects that are involved. But we have deployed many resources.
Colonel Milstead, good luck, sir. And if anyone's watching and's got a tip, do call the colonel. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. This is very important to the agency, and I hope somebody wants to go after the reward, because this is an act of cowardice, and people's lives are at risk.
That's right. There's a $20,000 reward. Colonel, thank you, sir.
Thank you, Greta, for having me on.